Hello scholars, welcome back to our online classes of GK. Today we are going to start our unit 2. But before that, I know you all are waiting to know the answers of the questions which I have asked in my last video. So let's see the answers. Our question number 1 was, who was the first Twitter user to reach 20 million followers? The answer is Lady Gaga. Lady Gaga just became the first Twitter user to reach 20 million followers. Now, we'll see our question number 2. Where can you find cities, towns, shops and streets but no people? The answer is map. In a map, we can find all of these but no people. So now scholars will move to do the exercise of our book. Scholars, today we will start our second unit, that is flora and fauna. Before starting this chapter, we should know what is flora and fauna. Flora is all the plant life present in a particular region or time, generally the naturally occurring native plants. And the corresponding term for animal life is fauna. In simple words, the flora relates to all plant life and the term fauna represents all animal life. So let's start this unit. So let's start with our exercise number 9, that is animal kingdom. Here we can see the picture given with each question and can guess the name of these animals. So let's start our, so scholars, here is our question number 1. Which is the world's smallest bird? As you can see in the picture also, yes, it is bee hummingbird, only found in Cuba. It measures a mere 2.25 inches long and they weigh less than 2 grams. This is bee hummingbird. Now we'll move to our question number 2. Which bird has the longest beak? As you can see in the picture given, the answer is pelican. Now we'll move to our question number 3. What is the female of a fox called? Yes, you are right. It is vixen. Now, question number 4. What is the special long winter sleep of some animals called? It is called hibernation. During the harsh winter months, many animals have adopted a special way of surviving the frigid temperature, that is called hibernation. Animals that hibernate have a unique way of slowing down their body functions, so they can essentially sleep away the winter months. Now we'll move to our question number 5. Name the biggest carnivorous land animal which is found in the Arctic region. The answer is polar bear. Now we'll move to our question number 6. What is the main food of a seal? You know that? Yes, it's right. It is fish. And you know, scholars, the seal use their whiskers for locating prey in these predominantly turbid waters. Now we are moving to question number 7. So here is our question number 7. Which is the fastest flying bird in the world? The answer is peregrine falcon. You know, scholars, it is not only the fastest flying bird in the world, but in fact the fastest animal on the earth when in a dive. Now we'll see our question number 8. Which fish swims upstream to lay eggs? The answer is salmon. Now we'll see our question number 9. Which bird makes the longest migratory flight in a year from Arctic to Antarctic and back? Yes, you are right. The answer is Arctic tern. The Arctic tern makes the longest migration of any animal in the world. So here we have completed our exercise number 9. Now we'll see our exercise number 10. So scholars, here is our exercise number 10, that is endangered animals. What are endangered animals? A species of animals is said to be endangered if it is feared to become extinct. A species becomes extinct when it has no living member of its species. So here in this exercise, we will learn about some of the endangered animals. So let's start. Here is our question number 1. This large bird, which is also one of the heaviest flying birds, was once found commonly in India. Due to hunting and habitat destruction, it is now on the verge of extinction. It is Great Indian Bustard. Once widespread, the species is today found mainly in central and western India. Now we'll see our question number 2. This animal is found in the mountainous regions of India, Nepal, China and Central Asia. There are only about 6,000 animals of this species left in the wild. The answer is snow leopard. Now we'll see our question number 3. Once found in large numbers in India, population of these animals declined by 99% between 2000 to 2007 due to ill effects of a medicine given to the cattle whose dead bodies they fed upon. Can you recognize this animal from the picture? Yes, it is Indian vulture. Now we'll move to question number 4. These are highly intelligent animals of Central Africa. They are highly endangered because of the habitat destruction, disease and poaching. Yes, the answer is gorilla. Now we'll move to our question number 5. These are the largest animals of the cat family. They can reach a length of 11 feet and have a weight of more than 300 kg. Highly endangered because of illegal hunting. Yes, you are right. The answer is tiger. Tigers are highly endangered because of the illegal hunting. Now we'll move to the last question of this exercise. So here is our question number 6. This animal is found throughout the Himalayan region. It has become endangered due to hunting and habitat destruction by humans. The answer is the Asian black bear. Like this, we have completed our exercise number 10. Now we'll move to our exercise 11. So here is our exercise number 11, amazing animals. In this exercise, we will learn about some amazing features of some animals. Here we have to match the animals shown below to the amazing features that they have. So let's see. Our question number A is, this fish can fill its body with water to swell up in size and scare away predators. You know which animal is this? It is puffer fish. You can see this animal in point number 3. The puffer fish, also called blowfish. They are named for their ability to inflate themselves to several times their normal size by swelling water or air when threatened. So here in front of A, we will write 3. Now we'll see our question number B. This animal can give you an electric shock. Yes, you are right. It is electric eel. This electric eel is also known as genus Electrophorus, any of 3 species of elongated South American knife fishes that produce powerful electric shocks to stun prey, usually other fish. All 3 species, Electrophorus electricus, E. wary and E. volatile, are found in Amazon River or its tributaries. So here in front of B, we will write 5. Our question number C is, this is the second largest bird. It has dagger-like claws with which it can even attack and kill humans. Our answer is cassowary. You can see the picture given in point number 8. Now we will read our question number D. Males of this fish store eggs in their brood pouches and rear the young ones. The answer is seahorse. It is given in option 1. So in front of D, we will write 1. Now we'll see our question number E. This fish dangles a light from its snout to attract its prey. The answer is anglerfish. It is given in point number 7. So in front of E, we will write 7. So here is our question number F. These fish can stripe away flesh from the body of a large prey in minutes using their razor sharp tip. It is piranha. It is given in point number 2. You can see the picture. So here in front of F, we will write 2. Now here is our question number G. This is considered as the laziest mammal in the world. It is 3-toed sloth. It is given in point number 6. You can see its picture. And you know, they are so lazy that they sleep for up to 20 hours a day and are known for being extremely slow moving. So here in front of G, we will write 6. Now we reach to our last point, that is H. This is the largest predatory fish of the seas. Yes, you are right. It is great white shark. It is given in point number 4. So in front of H, we will write 4. So like this, we have completed our exercise number 11. Now we'll see our exercise number 12. So here is our exercise number 12, animal terminology. Here we will know about the different terms which is used for animals. So here in this exercise, we have to match each description under column A to the term it describes under column B. So let's start. Our first question is, flap-like loose skin hanging from the neck of an animal. This term is dewlap. It is given in point number B. So in front of 1, we will write B. Now we'll see question number 2. An organism that lives on or inside the body of another animal. This term is called parasite. It is given in point number E. So in front of 2, we will write E. Now we'll see our question number 3. Animals that do not have a spinal column. All insects come in this category. They are known as invertebrates. It is given in point number G. So in front of 3, we will write G. Now we'll see our question number 4. A group of invertebrates having a segmented body an external skeleton and attached legs with joints. This term is known as arthropods. It is given in point number J. So in front of 4, we will write J. Now we will see our question number 5. An animal that feeds on the remains of dead plants and animals. This term is called detritivore. It is given in point number C. So in front of 5, we will write C. Now we'll see our question number 6. Marine and freshwater animals with soft bodies which are often covered with a hard shell. It is mollusk. It is given in point number F. So we will write F in front of 6. Now we'll see our question number 7. The nose-like structure in some invertebrates that is like a tube and helps them to suck. It is called proboscis. It is given in point number D. So we will write D in front of 7. Now moving to our next question. Animal that hunts and eats other animals. They are called? Yes, it is predator. It is given in point number I. So in front of 8, we will write I. Now we'll move to our next question. Herbivorous, hooved, cut-chewing mammals that have unique digestive system with more than one stomach compartment. This term is known as ruminants. It is given in point number A. Here. So in front of 9, we will write A. It is ruminant. Now we'll see our last question. An animal that can self-fertilize as it contains both male and female reproductive organs. This term is known as hermaphrodite. It is given in point number H. So here in front of 10, we will write H. So like this, we have completed our exercise number 12 also. Now, I want you all to complete all these exercises in your book and please keep on revising. Now, we are moving towards our next segment. So scholars, today in the segment of Amazing Fact, we'll learn about black apples. Yes, you heard right. Black apples exist. These extremely rare apples look like something out of a fairy tale. Black diamond apples are a rare variety from the family of Huanyu apples, also known as the Chinese Red Delicious. The name is a little misleading because they are not exactly black, but rather a dark color of purple. These unique apples owe their color to their native geography in Ningxi, a small city in the mountains of Tibet, where they receive a lot of ultraviolet light during the day, but the temperature fluctuates dramatically at night, causing the skin to develop a deep dark color. The flesh inside is white and bright like any other apple. So next time if you get a chance to visit Tibet, don't forget to have these apples. Now let's move to our next segment, that is Know Your Country. Today in this segment we are going to learn about one interesting fact about India, that is the floating post office. With 1,55,618 post offices and over 5,66,000 employees, India has the largest postal network in the world. But did you know India is also having a floating post office? The floating post office is located in the beautiful city of Srinagar in Kashmir. Amidst picturesque snow-clad mountains on a huge houseboat in Dal Lake. More than 7,000 people use this post office every year and is still growing strong. In fact,
The surprising factor here is that it is not the only floating post office in India but also in the world, which makes it a unique piece of architecture. Being one of its kind architectures, this post office has now become an important place of a tourist's Kashmir itinerary. Now we'll move to our next segment, that is current affair. Today's current affair is about the app Money to help visually challenged to identify currency notes. Recently, the Reserve Bank of India, RBI, has launched a mobile app, Mobile Aided Note Identifier, that is Money. The visually challenged people can identify the denominations of a currency note by using the mobile app Money. This application also works offline once installed. This application scans the currency notes using the camera of the mobile phone and also gives audio output in Hindi and English. This app does not authenticate a note as either genuine or counterfeit. But overall, it is going to be a very helpful app for visually challenged people.
So scholars, I hope you like this segment. Now we'll see our homework. Today you have to find the answer of this question. So your question is, name the only food that does not spoil. So scholars, with this, we come to end of this video. Goodbye, scholars.